The engine doesn't seem to be running correctly or well, in my opinion. It is way down on power.
That was a bad one there.
And this is what they look like. They're already full of soot. Finally feels like there's something under the hood.
Whoa, that's nice. That is so nice. It's like so smooth now.
Welcome back. So if you caught my last video, I talked a little bit at the end about some issues we're having with our 73 Nova LS swap. One of those issues is a vibration. I'm getting it at, let's say, I start feeling around 40, 45 miles per hour, and it's like a pulsating vibration. So the frequency of the pulses and how long they are changes with vehicle speed. It's weird. So I've got some things to check out with that. But in this video, I'm going to talk about another issue we're having, and that is with the engine. The engine doesn't seem to be running correctly or well, in my opinion. It seems to be running maybe a little bit on the rough side. It's hard to tell at idle because of the camshaft. But giving it some throttle and letting it go through the gears, I noticed it is way down on power. Like this engine doesn't seem to be making any power. And it's kind of I can only describe it as like a chugging. It's not, the car doesn't chug along, but the engine sounds like it's struggling. Maybe a miss or something like that that's happening. I'm not sure. It's hard to explain. I'm going to try to catch it on video if it does it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the plugs today. They are a little bit fouled out from too much fuel. If you guys remember way back when we first cranked the engine and then we put the Holley system on and first cranked the engine, we were getting a lot of fuel dumped in the cylinders because it just wasn't tuned in. And originally, the whole right or passenger side bank of the engine was getting too much fuel or wasn't getting any spark because I did forget the ground wire for the coils on that side of the engine. So anyway, like I said before, also in my other video, we are working with a tuner and he requested that I take a data log before I change the plugs because he wants to see what the car is doing. And I'm gonna try to catch on this video when the car is sitting there idling, I can kind of pat the throttle, just give it a little bit of gas to raise the RPM up. Not a whole lot, maybe 1500 RPM or so. And it gives a little hesitation, hard to describe, but kind of a little skip or a little miss or something like that with a little bit of throttle input, quick throttle input. So I'm going to try to catch that on the video, see if you guys can hear that. But like I said, we're going to take a data log. He wants to check it out. Before I change the plug. So I'm gonna do all that, change the plugs, and then we'll take the car down the road and see if anything improves with new spark plugs. I really hope this helps because I'm not sure where else to go other than the tuning. They are pretty fouled out with fuel. So hopefully that is all that it is and the car runs great after that. That would be awesome, but that's not how my luck goes. But we'll see. Let me get going. Let's get this data log done so we can change these plugs and see how it does. All right, so hopefully you guys can hear me and hopefully you can hear the engine well. I'm just gonna kind of blip the throttle, just a light little blip, and I wanna see if I can pick this up on camera. Hopefully you guys can hear it and I'm not just losing my mind here, so. But here we go, let me do a few of these and see if I can catch it on this video. Did it right there. All was a bad one there. So I don't know if y'all are catching that, but let me data log this so I can get it sent to the tuner, and then I'll change the plugs. All right, so real quick, I'm going to take the car out and do a test drive and take a data log and see what we can find out. But these are the plugs that come out. Now, I had wire brushed them off and cleaned them up a little bit before I reinstalled them. And then ran the car last night and then ran it again today for the data log that I told you about earlier. And this is what they look like. They're already full of soot. So I think we have too much fuel going on. But these are gapped. I can't remember what they're gapped at, but I know they're probably below 50 thousandths. The new plugs, I'm putting them in right out of the box, and it's about 55 thousandths. So I'm going to try that, maybe a wider gap. I don't know if that will help with the combustion. We'll see. But I'm going to take it down the road. I won't be able to film it because I need to data log as well, so I need a couple hands while I'm doing this. So just bear with me. I'm going to take it down the road, and I'll be back to let you guys know how it did and my thoughts on it. And yeah, we'll see what happens. So let me get this car running and down the road, and I'll be back. All right, y'all. So went down the road, made a quick little pull, and drove the car around a little bit. And man, night and day difference in this car. Couldn't believe it. Spark plugs. Oh man, spark plugs. But I did talk to my tuner on the phone, and he had me data log a short pull and download the latest global file, which is basically the tune. So he wanted to see all that. He's gonna look it over this evening and see what he thinks. We may make a spark plug change. He has a suggestion on another plug that he says runs better in these engines. So we'll try that. Man, I hate that I did not have you guys along for the ride, because the car pulled pretty strong. It finally feels like there's something under the hood. I'm gonna interrupt this video right here because I can't let this video out without some driving footage and the reaction of Miss Nova Castile to the newfound power in our 73 Nova LS swap. So we're letting the car warm up for a second, and we're gonna take off, and hopefully she won't scare me with her driving again. Second gear, put it in drive. Oh my god.
Still feels good. Whoa, gotta watch this air.
Alright, let's. Maybe I'm gonna try to jump, not scrape. Jump! Oh no, we still scrape.
Hold my breath.
But it just feels so much smoother.
Yeah, it does.
Like, give it a little gas.
Give it a little gas?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything. Like, do you feel that pulsing anymore?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't.
I feel feel anything. It just
like
feels
over
like,
here, it feels like super smooth.
Yeah. That's what it feels like. Go straight or what?
I don't know. No, go to the light. Okay. Take a right.
Go open them Shreks. Need to work on these brakes though.
The brakes work good. And then right here, just kind of. So you can give it a little bit of gas, but don't hit that car.
I feel it shifting. Whoa.
How's it feel?
That's nice.
Yeah, I mean, you weren't hardly giving any gas, were you?
No. All right, let's go to Mexico.
I hope it's not too much noise in
it. I got my passport.
Totally different car, though.
Yeah.
It's night and day different.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Is it, like, I don't know, it felt like it was, like, I guess, raggedy?
Yeah, it felt like an old farm truck. Like
yeah.
You were driving an old farm truck with an exhaust leak. And yeah.
It was just, like, all the rattling and the... It was just rough. I mean, it wasn't, like, rough. This is just smooth, like, really smooth.
There you have it. Miss Nova approves. And put the camera away. We're going to head to the store. We got to get a few things. And then I'll go back to the original video and close this one out. Oh, man. It was nice. It pulled really well. And as far as the vibration, that may have cleared up. I need to do some more driving to make sure. But, man, it... Night and day. Couldn't believe it. Night and day. So, man, we are getting somewhere with the Nova as far as the power, and we'll get there with drivability. It's going to be there, and Miss Nova Castile is going to be extremely happy with this. I have no doubt. I'm already happy, and we're not even done tuning. We're in the middle of tuning it still. So, man, I can't wait until she's fully tuned in. We got a few other things to do. I need to, get the pinion angle right on it. I think that may be a slight cause to the vibration, but we made some major steps forward today. And man, I couldn't be happier. If things keep getting better with this car, keeps running better, man, I'm going to be ecstatic. So anyway, I know there wasn't a lot to see in this video, but I wanted to bring you guys along with this process of figuring out what's going on with the car and share that, you know, we're having some issues. So that's all part of this hobby. I was kind of frustrated the other day because it just wasn't running well, and I was just extremely frustrated. So anyway, it's a good thing we checked the plugs and tried a new set, really. And I knew they needed to be changed because we had gone through all those fueling issues. I knew they needed to be changed, but I didn't even think that they would make that much difference. So anyway, I'm going to end this one here. Hope you liked it. If you did, hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please do so, because we've got more coming, and we're going to be doing burnouts and donuts in this car. And we'll see you on the next one.